Good afternoon, class 12 children. Today we are again dealing with the 9th chapter of human evolution. Now yesterday, children, we had studied in the first video about the origin of man. We also saw biologists like Thomas Henry Huxley, Charles Darwin, Carolus Linnaeus, and we saw their contribution in biological evolution and even more in human evolution. We studied about the early human ancestors like Dryopithecus, which was discovered in an era prior to ape man. And we also saw minutely the differences between ape and man in yesterday's video. But today we see another ancestor prior to ape man, which is called Ramapithecus. This ancestor, which is prior to the ape man, we see is Ramapithecus, which you see here on page number 350. And let's look at the features of this Ramapithecus. You see here in the features of Ramapithecus that the fossils, they were discovered 12 to 14 million years old. So one of the features, and these fossils were found in the old Pliocene rocks of Shivalik Hills, India, by Lewis in 1930, and from Lake Victoria, Africa, by Leake in 1955. If we look at the skull, children, here, the skull was small, delicate jaws with semicircular teeth line. The semicircular teeth line was there, and we see that the teeth here, you see the teeth here, the teeth are small canines that were flattened molars with the thicker enamel. We see the diet of these, they ate seeds and nuts. These creatures, they ate seeds and nuts. Then we see that the posture of these, they were partially upright, they walked partially upright. And the importance or the significance of these creatures called Ramapithecus were, they were the earliest hominids ground dwelling in the savanna. It was a direct ancestor representing the family Hominidae. Then we come next to the ape man, the African ape man here, or this is called as Australopithecus, or the ape man Australopithecus. One of the pictures is given here of Australopithecus. We will see another picture of it for more details of its dental makeup, etc. Raymond Dart in 1924 discovered a fossil baby skull, and in this fossil baby skull we see that this belonged to a small baby ape-like man, and this was from the Pliocene era rocks, 4 million years old, and this was found in a place called Twang Town, and that is why this is the skull of a Twang baby. It was named as a Twang baby. Raymond named it Australopithecus africanus. Australopithecus is the genus and africanus is the species. The skull had large jaws, which you see here. It has got large jaws like that of a man, and it had small cranial capacity of about 600 centimeter cube, and had the teeth like the teeth of man. The diet of this, they were omnivorous, and they majorly ate meat. The posture of these Australopithecus animals, were that they were 150 centimeter tall. Pelvic girdle shows that they walked almost erect. They had low forehead and brow bridges and projecting jaws. They had low forehead, brow bridges and projecting jaws. Over the eyes, protruding face. And there was lack of chin. There was a lumbar curve in the vertebral column. Then we see the importance or the significance was that it lived in caves, used pebbles and bones as tools and defense and for hunting, etc. Then we come to another specimen of Homo habilis. Another specimen, Homo habilis. This was also known as the handyman or a tool man, because this used tools after making it. It was a tool maker. And the fossil was discovered by Louis Leakey in 1960. This prehistoric man was from 1.6 to 1.8 million years old. In the Pleistocene rocks of Olduvai Gorge in East Africa were these found. The skull of this was having large brain, as you can see here, with a cranial capacity of about 689 centimeter cube. And the teeth, its lower jaw, we see the lower jaw here, was lightly built, and the dentition was more like that of modern man. Its dentition is almost like that of modern man. And we see that its diet contained that it was omnivorous. It had the posture of like a man. It walked erect and lived in open grassy lands. The significance or the importance of this creature, Homo habilis, was that it was capable of making tools of stone and used them for hunting, etc. So it was capable of making tools of stone, which it used for hunting, for defense against other enemies. And Leakey claimed that Homo habilis was the prehistoric man and was the nearest ancestor of man. Then we come on to another one, which was a ape-like man, which we see here is Java ape man, Homo erectus, Java ape man. Its fossils were discovered, the Java ape man fossils were discovered by a Dutch anatomist, Eugene Du Bois. And in 1891, when it was discovered, it was found that it was in the Pleistocene rocks that was 17 million years old on the banks of a Solo River at Trenil in Java. That's why it is known as the Java ape man. And we see the skull, its forehead, you see, was receding with prominent brow ridges. You see, this the skull is receding slowly towards the prominent brow ridges, which are protruding out. Then we see that the cranial capacity of the Java man was about 900 centimeter cube, which is the largest till now in all the ape-like men that we have seen. Then we see that the teeth of this, if you see in this diagram, we see the teeth clearly. The heavy jaws were prognathous, protruding forward with almost no chin. It had almost no forward chin, but the chin is almost obscured and hidden. The teeth were large, but quite like those of the modern man. Large teeth like the modern man, except large canines of the lower jaw. Only in the lower jaw there was a difference, as this Java man had large canines, but we do not have protruding canines. The lips were thick and protruding. Then we see that the diet of the Java man was, it was omnivorous, and probably it was a cannibal, and its posture was fully erect, just like human beings. It stood absolutely erect on its feet. The significance or the importance was that it made very, very sophisticated tools, which you can see here. He shaped the tools very well out of stone, and even made tools out of bones. Even he sharpened the bones to make axes. You see, he made axe-like tools for cutting wood, etc. He made use of fire for the first time, for hunting, for defense, for cooking, and was much nearer to the modern man than the ape. So, children, we will study up till here today in this video, and tomorrow we will start with the study of the early man. So, children, wish you all the best for today. Have a good day. Thank you.